everybody. Welcome to another episode of Charlie Has Dolls. What do we have here? Another box. We're going to go ahead and unbox this today. I've already unboxed it for the most part, but I wanted to go ahead and show you guys what I got in this because this is one of those wild card boxes. I didn't actually know what everything was in here. I had an idea for the dolls at least, but it came with a couple more items than I was expecting. So let's go ahead and look at what I received. Since the box is already open, I decided to set some of these items up. As you can see, it did come with quite a few playset items. Unfortunately, none of them are like the full set. You have a Ghoulia scooter, 13 Wishes DJ playset with that came with a Spectra doll. There's a the Freak Du Cheek circus items, but those were the only pieces it came with. The Creepeteria items, which is the table, chair, and the little food display thingy here. And then this one is a school hangout room. And I think this one was just missing the foosball table. And then there was also pieces for Abby's bed. The only part missing was like her main bed and pillow, I believe. So there's that. And then there was also, you know, a baggie of some stands and other pieces that came with it. So now let's go ahead and look at the dolls. So the first doll I'm going to show you is Casta Fierce. In the little baggie of accessories I showed you guys, she does have her broom and microphone in there. And then the next doll in this lot is a Swim Class Draculaura. Super cute. She has her sunglasses. I believe her towel is also in the accessory lot. Next we have a Draculaura Rebecca crossover Freaky Fusion. I think her name is Drewbecca. She is missing quite a few of her accessories, like her earrings, her wings, and goggles, but I think this is probably the prettiest of all the Freaky Fusion dolls. And then next we have a Freaky Field Trip Gigi Gramp. So in another haul I had received her with no shoes, and then in this one I received one with just shoes. So I'm gonna go ahead and take her shoes off and add her to the other doll that has clothing still. And then next we have Scaris Rochelle. As you can see, I showed you guys that I did get a few of the, no, Scaris Rochelle, Freak Du Cheek Rochelle. I did receive some of the playset pieces, so she was in the lot too. Also in this lot was Honey Swamp. So here she is, and it's cool because she still has her little puppet hanging pieces attached. Then we have a Swim Class Laguna, which I've gotten like 3 or 4 of these now, and I've sold all the other ones that I've previously received, so she's probably going to go in the sell pile as well. Here we have a Catty Noir. Unfortunately, she's missing a boot, so she's bootless, but she does have her earrings, I believe. And next we have Festival Abby. This one actually has her little festival badge, but she's missing her little bandana that she goes around her hair. So she is. Here we have Scaremaster Twyla. So she has her bag also, but I noticed that her hair is a little short here. I don't know if this is normal for this doll or if it was cut somehow. But she's here. I actually like her look. And then with that Twyla, there was another Twyla that came, but I've already set her up in one of my setups. But this is a Coffee Bean Twyla. I did have a Coffee Bean Twyla, but this one had her drink, so I'm going to keep her. And there she is. And then we have a Freaky Field Trip Toralai. I don't really care much for this doll, but yeah, I'll just put it there. And then next are some re-release dolls. Re-release Draculaura. You can tell she's re-released because she has the printed on buttons instead of the white buttons in her first release form. And I think there's a couple other differences, but I can't remember. She had a longer hair too in her first release. And then her necklace too, it's solid here, but it was more detailed initially. But she has all of her pieces, so there she is. And then there was also a re-release Cleo doll right here. And you can tell, like, when they re-released these, the details went away because, like, her little hairband. And I do have her little foam piece that goes on her thigh, but those are all solid color. Her shoes are solid color instead of the gold and black that they were when she was initially released. And then next we have a Vondela Doubloons. Her hat is somewhere here, but I already have this doll as well, so she's complete, which is nice. And then I'm going to show you guys the dolls that I was most excited about receiving. So, well, let me show you these two first, and then I'll show you the two that I was most excited about receiving. So here we have I'm putting them back together. Ghouls Getaway Gina Fire and Spectra. So I love the whole design of Ghouls Getaway. I think it's so freaking pretty. The whole little tropical tiki vibes is probably one of their best ones, in my opinion, since between the Haunted series and the Sweet Screams, I really just overall like the design of these ones. With that said, the other Ghouls Getaway doll I received was, oh, let me get her fixed up, Elisabeth. So this doll is so hard to find, or when I do find her, she is ridiculously priced. Unfortunately, she is missing a couple of things, like one earring right here and a hand, which is not really a big deal because I do have a bag of like extra hands, and she has the same skin tone as Draculaura, which makes it easy to match, but she's here. So now I am going to work to hunt down an earring and one of these little tassel things, which I know will probably be harder, you know, easier said than done. But regardless, I have an Elisabeth Ghouls Getaway, so I'm super excited to add her to my collection. And then the last one, this was actually the doll that sold me on buying a lot, and as soon as I saw her in the tub with all the other dolls. That is Monster Exchange Draculaura. And the reason why this one had me super duper excited to receive her was because she actually had the connecting hairpiece to her bow. Usually when I see this doll secondhand, it only has her bow and not this piece. But because it had this piece, I immediately wanted to buy this lot. And then all the other dolls were pretty much just bonuses. So here she is. She's complete. She was missing her purse, but I managed to find a purse. And then magically her hair is, it's a little messy. I could fix it, but it's still kind of attached in its original form. But yeah, that's her. So that's my lot, guys. These are all the dolls that I received in this box, a couple of play sets. I'm probably gonna look to complete some of them, but I don't know yet. We'll see. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and join me for the next one. Bye.